Hello, welcome back to my channel. My name is Dani and today it's time for more March wrap up. So let's talk about books. In March I read 6 books. 4 of them were 5 stars. Well, one was a reread of a 5 star book and it was still 5 stars. And I also read a 1 star book and one book that I decided not to rate, and you're gonna understand why. I'm gonna tell you in chronological order what I read. So let's start with An Unwanted Guest by Sherry Lapina. This book was selected in my M&M's TBR. I'm gonna link that video there in the cards if you wanna check that out. And I gave this 5 stars. It was also on a 5 star prediction, so I got it right. This book is about a group of people who get snowed in a hotel in the middle of nowhere, and they don't have cell phone connection, they don't have internet, everything is like not working, and in one morning a person appears dead. So now they're all trying to figure out what happened, who did it. This was the perfect cozy mystery book that I was looking for. It had this exact Agatha Christie vibe that I was looking for as well, but more modern. It was very thrilling. It was very unexpected for me, a lot of it. Like there were some things that were a little bit expected, but a lot I did not expect. This is the second book by Sherry Lapina that I gave 5 stars. I really like her writing. It really gets me in the book. It's very immersive and it keeps me hooked. This book specifically, it didn't have like the biggest plot twist ever. It was just a lot of fun and very well written cozy mystery thriller. So I really recommend if you're looking for this specific vibe in a book. The next book I read in March was volume 1 of the comic book Mr. Miracle by Tom King. And this was the book that I decided to not give any star ratings because this was just not written for me. Like, I'm not the person who should be rating this book because I had no idea what I read. I am not used to reading comic books and I'm not used to the DC universe. I really don't know a lot about it. So I had no idea what was going on. I felt like the scenes kept jumping everywhere and I was so lost. I didn't know who was whom, and they kept mentioning scene and the situation and events and other characters from DC that I didn't know. So it's just like not the right book for me to read. This was recommended to me. I really get it. I get that this looks like it's a very interesting story. I'm just not the person who should be reading it. So it felt a lot like when I read Before Vendetta last year, which is like a really good story, but I'd rather read it in another format. I don't know how to explain. It's just like if you're used to reading comic books and if you know a little bit of the DC universe, I do recommend it. I think you'd love it. There are very cool topics dealt in this comic, but I can't even tell you the plot. Like, it's a superhero, I don't remember, I don't know. The next book I read in March was Bruiser by Neil Schusterman. This was also picked by the M&Ms, and this was also on my 5-star prediction video, and this was also 5 stars. This is a very hard book to describe without spoilers, and I feel like I did give away a few spoilers in the M&Ms video, when I talked about it, because I didn't know, I was like going by what's written here, I guess, or what I heard other people say. But this tells a story of a few different people. So first we meet 2 siblings, and the girl starts dating a boy from school, and her brother doesn't really like this boy. We also hear the story of this boy and his little brother. And I think there's a 5th point of view here that I'm forgetting maybe, but it's pretty much those 4 people are the most important ones. And when they get closer to this boy that she's dating, who the character is called Bruiser here, his name is Brewster, and when they get closer to him, some weird stuff starts happening. As with other Neil Schusterman's books, this takes a very, like, a real thing that exists in the world and takes it to an almost extreme level. And in this case, what is the important like plot point here is that this boy, Brewster, he is an empath. And I'm not gonna tell you a lot more than this. If you want to know a little bit more of the story, feel like it's not even necessarily a spoiler, because the way that the story is written, I think, is more important than the plot itself. But you can go on that video, and I gave away a little bit more there. But I don't want to say anything else if you are just hearing about this book for the first time. And like I mentioned, this was in my 5-star predictions, but I did not predict that this book was going to be the way that it was. I thought it was going to be a light, fluffy fantasy, kind of like contemporary with a little bit of fantasy in it, and just light, especially, which is not what this book was. It was very intense and hard-hitting and a very relatable story, especially with the siblings whose parents are getting divorced. It was very, like, getting very near home there for me. But the story of Brewster and his brother, when I hear, when I finally get the point of view of his brother, like, it was breaking my heart hearing that story. So I really do recommend this book. It's not light and fluffy. It's very heavy. Not, like, it's still a contemporary with fantasy elements in it. But it's a heavy one. Of course, they're heavier, but I don't know. It's just, I just did not expect that it was going to be like this. And it surprised me in the best way possible. All the point of views are very different. They have such a different voice. And they all connect so beautifully in the end. I already said this, the way he writes just speaks to me. And I really enjoyed this so, so, so much. And I do recommend it. The next book I read in March was The Jet Setters by Amanda Eyre Ward. This was 1-star. I already have a video with a dedicated review for this book. I'm going to link that in the cards. So if you want to know more about it, you should check that. This is about a 70-year-old woman who wins a cruise to go around Europe, and her children go with her in this cruise because they want to reconnect, and they all have weird, intense stuff going on in their lives. I didn't like this book at all. I thought this premise was barely touched upon, and there were some very problematic themes here that were not addressed well. I don't recommend it, but I do recommend that you check my review. And I also talked about how I'm not going to keep reading the Reese Witherspoon book clubs anymore, and instead I'm going to read the Alcrae books. So go into that video to know more about all of this. Let's go back to 5-star books. The next book I read in March was Only Human by Sylvain Novel. This is the third book in the Themis Files. I finally completed the trilogy. This was not in the M&Ms. This was not in my TBR. I just needed a good book after I read The Jet Setters. And I just wanted to pick this one up. And it was the best thing I could have done. This whole series was 5-stars for me. I enjoyed it so much. This, well, the first book in the trilogy tells a story about, well, starts with a girl falling onto a giant metal hand. And when she's an adult, she's a scientist and she's studying this metal hand and other things, weird things that are going on. And it's basically about giant alien robots. And if you like sci-fi at all, I really think you should read this trilogy. It's so much fun. It's so well written. And it's written in files. It's like we have interview files, we have diary files. It goes very fast. The audiobooks are all full cast. If you prefer to read in an audio format, I do recommend that as well. This book specifically, it was much more social and political, and I did enjoy that. I thought I really enjoyed seeing some of the characters here grow and develop, and I love seeing their relationship. And I adore the ending. I think the ending was great. It is one of my favorite trilogies now. I can say this for sure. And I do recommend it. And the last book that I read in March was a reread for me, and it was a 5-star book, and that was Nevermoor by Jessica Townsend. I read this for my work book club, and I was so happy to reread this book and to go into this story again. I picked up on so many more things that I didn't the first time, so it just complemented the story so much for me, and I really want to read Wundersmith again as well before Hollowpox comes out. If you're new here, I can't stop talking about Nevermoor. You're gonna hear a lot of it in my channel, probably. This tells a story about a girl who is cursed and she's supposed to die on her 11th birthday, but a strange man comes to her house and takes her to Nevermoor, which is a magical land, and wants her to go into the Wonder Society. There she has to fulfill a few trials to get in, and that's just what the premise is about on the first one. This book is very, very whimsical, is very nonsensical. I feel like it has the best aspect of Alice in Wonderland and Harry Potter for me. There's a lot of sarcasm. I think Jupiter North, which is the strange man who takes her to Nevermoor, his humor reminds me a lot of David Tennant as the Doctor in Doctor Who. And it's just an amazing story. So much fun. I really recommend if you want something fun and just to be happy with a book. That's what I would go for sure. Let me know if you read any of these books and what you thought about them. And remember to like this video and to subscribe to my channel. And thank you so much for joining me today. Bye!